Hi, I'm Max Dalton, and in this video, I'm going to talk through how to add, delete, and move recorded audio in the Microsoft OneNote app. The Microsoft OneNote app for iOS and Android devices makes it easy for users to quickly capture audio recordings and save those in a OneNote notebook. The feature makes it easy to capture valuable conversations that you may not otherwise be able to record, and then store those in an organized environment that's simple to share with other people. You can access the recording feature with a quick tap on any page within the OneNote application. You can also move, rename, delete, and even assign alternative text for your captured audio files quickly. How to record audio. Step 1. Navigate to the page in OneNote where you want to include recorded audio. Step 2. Tap any location in the body of the page. A keyboard and menu fly up from the bottom of the screen. Step 3. Tap the microphone icon in the list of icons. The recording audio window appears in the center of the screen. The window displays the level of the audio being captured, the total duration of the audio recording, and a stop recording button. Step 4. Press Stop Recording when you're finished capturing the audio you want to store on that OneNote page. The recording audio window disappears and you're returned to the body of the page you were viewing. An audio file icon and a timestamp associated with the date and time of the recording now appear in the body of the page. How to play recorded audio files. Step 1. Navigate to any page containing an audio recording you captured. Step 2. Tap the audio file icon. A symbol with four arrows appears on top of the icon. A context menu opens above the icon, and a play button appears to the left of the icon. Step 3. Tap the play button to the left of the audio icon, or navigate to and tap play in the context menu. An audio player appears on your screen and automatically starts playing the audio file. Step 4. Tap Close to stop playing and close your audio file, and return to the body of the page you were on. How to delete recorded audio files. Maybe the recording didn't pan out the way you want, and you want to do it again. Maybe it contained sensitive information you don't want discovered, or maybe you're just looking to free up space on your device. Regardless of the reason, deleting an audio recording in the Microsoft OneNote app can be done quickly. Step 1. Navigate to the page containing the captured OneNote audio you want to delete. Step 2. Tap the audio file icon. Step 3. Tap Delete in the context menu. The audio file is instantly deleted. It's worth noting that the timestamp will still remain and will need to be deleted separately. How to move audio files. When you capture an audio recording, the audio file icon and timestamp get placed at the location where your cursor was when you started recording the audio. As a result, the resulting file doesn't always get placed where you want it to go. If that happens, you can easily move the file to a different location within the page. Step 1. Navigate to the page containing the captured audio recording you want to move. Step 2. Tap the audio file icon. Step 3. Hold your finger against the symbol appearing over the audio file icon containing four arrows, and then move the file icon to the location where you want it to appear on the page. You'll notice that as you move the file icon, other text on the page will move to accommodate it. Step 4. Remove your finger from the audio file icon to complete the move. Separately, the timestamp doesn't move with the audio file icon, and you'll need to move that separately. How to rename audio files. By default, the name of any captured audio file will be a generic audio and then a number. To make it easy to identify later, you may want to change the name of the audio file, which can be done in a few seconds. Step 1. Navigate to the page containing the captured audio recording you want to rename. Step 2. Tap the audio file icon. Step 3. Select Rename in the context menu. The rename window appears. Step 4. Enter the name you want to assign to that specific audio file, and then tap Save. you'll be returned to the page where the audio file is located, and the audio file will now display the new name. How to assign alternative text to audio files. Alternative text shows up in the tooltip window that appears when users hold their cursors over a particular item, which in this case would be the audio file icon. However, alternative text comes into play for a number of accessibility features. For example, a user who is blind could listen to the alternative text to hear a description of the audio file to determine whether or not they wanted to listen to it. Assigning alternative text to your audio file is a quick process. Step 1. Navigate to the page containing the captured audio recording you want to assign alternative text to. Step 2. Tap the audio file icon. Step 3. Choose Alt Text in the context menu. The Alt Text window appears. Step 4. Enter a title and a description associated with your alternative text, and then tap Done. You'll be returned to the page where your audio file is located, and while you won't see any changes on the screen, this will be very useful for any individuals with accessibility needs who you may share your notebooks with.